Welcome to Son of the Most High channel. All praises to the Most High Yahuah, our brother Jedaniah, and I appreciate y'all tuning in to my channel. Let us return to our original heritage and culture of the Second Covenant in Yahusha. Hallelujah. Shalom, brothers and sisters. So let's just take a brief look at wisdom being called her. I know I covered this topic in the past. If you haven't seen those videos, go check it out. I just want to retouch on that previous videos I've done concerning the subject. So by now, if you've done your proper research and homework, you know that wisdom is not its own separate female entity outside of the Most High or outside of the Son. It's not its own this feminine entity sitting on a throne next to the Most High. It is part of his spirit. And part of this understanding is that in the translation, when they put her there, they didn't quite explain all the other definitions that come with that feminine woman or her title. Brothers and sisters, so that's the research you really have to dig into. If you know that the Most High never pointed you toward some separate female sitting next to him in any capacity in the book itself. So you have to get a deeper understanding on your own, brothers and sisters, by doing just a little research. So I looked up the word spouse, which means married, husband and wife, or married being paired. So you kind of start to understand, okay, when we look at the Most High being married to Yahshua'el, it doesn't necessarily mean that the man whose name was Jacob was changed to Yahshua'el. It doesn't necessarily mean that he has to be a woman. When he was married to Yahshua'el, it just meant they were paired. He became the Most High's possession. That's why when a man marries a woman, he has to pay the fee, the price, and she becomes his possession according to scriptures. So the Most High is paying a price. I mean, even for the Messiah, a price was paid. Y'all know what I'm saying? So that we may be married unto him. But it really was the Most High giving his life for all of us, that we may be returned back unto the Most High. So you see these correlations of the woman and how she's to be submissive, obedient. Her life is given as a sacrifice, and so much more, brothers and sisters. But it all correlates to the position of Yahusha. But the spirit, which is in the Most High, the Ruach Qadash, has many aspects to it, many attributes to it, including his almighty power. But that's just a part of him. That's just a part of his whole spirit, which he shares with the Son. And once we're inside the Son, he shares with us. So it doesn't necessarily mean woman when he's talking about her in certain verses when it's concerning wisdom. So if you look up, it's kind of hard to get to what exactly does her mean. You know, you look up in this blue letter Bible and you try to find the concordance version of the H Hebrew word, and you can't really find it. You see, you go over all of this. Where is it? Look at all this. I mean, it's highlighting it, but where's the H at in here? Nowhere to be found. So you got to be careful with these translations. So you got to dig just a little bit deeper. Go to the Strong's. And over here on the Bible Hub, we find that the word for woman, wife, female is Isha. And it means woman, wife, female. But there's more to this definition, brothers and sisters. Like I explained with that one word, new, when we looked it up in the video explaining the Most High's image in the scriptures. I mean, sorry, not the image in the scriptures, but the, we looked up the, what the second covenant is. Sorry about that. So you have to scroll down and look at some more stuff about that word. And right here it says marriage, Mary. Are paired, brothers and sisters, paired. So this word where it says her, let's go back over here, her, it's talking about wisdom. And if you break it down, this word here means submissive, obedient. It means paired, married, a part of, you know, it's a part of the Most High. This is the tone that these words mean for this. Most of us with our fleshly mind and thinking would just say, okay, it's just a woman. It's a female entity, female spirit of the Most High. And that's not the case. He never told you that. It's just in the translations. You have to get back to the roots of these, the different meanings. And through the Spirit of the Most High, he will show you what these words mean, brothers and sisters, so that when you go to Wisdom of Solomon, where he talks about her, you know, wisdom being her, and of course right here in Proverbs talks about wisdom being her, you have to put the right meanings in it. So let's go over here and let me just give you another example. Oops, it's not what I was trying to do. Sorry, y'all. Let me go back. Let me do this here. Jeremiah 31. Okay, 31 and 31. Okay, Jeremiah 31 and okay, right here. Okay, we got the word Hadassah for new. And so everybody just thinking, okay, new covenant, but there's more to the story, right? So you click on this or click on that, Strong's. And here you go. You got Qadash. Qadash. It means new. And you scroll down. This is the other definitions of that, right? But there's more to Qadash. You go back one more. Here you have the same word. Qadash. To renew, repair. Scroll down. Renew, renewed, repair, restore, restored. So now you can actually go to Jeremiah 31 and put in those same words to get the fuller meaning. This is what's called study yourself to be approved. So right here, behold, the days, saith, the days come, saith Yahuah, that I will make a new covenant with the house of Yasharal and the house of Judah. Now you replace that with that I will make a renewed, restored, repaired covenant. It gives you a broader meaning now. Now you can really look at it. So he's renewing, restoring the covenant with Moses through Yahusha. Yes. And now you can understand that none of that stuff is done away with now. So it's just being fixed. There's some stuff in there that needs to be fixed, and when it was given to Yahusha through Moses. So the Messiah came to fix that which was broken, so to say, within, or couldn't bring the fullness of the promises to Yahusha just yet. So that was repaired, restored, renewed. So now you go back to Proverbs 8:1. And you put in the other meanings when it's talking about her or she. You have to have that understanding, brothers and sisters. Because nowhere in the place, I mean, nowhere in within the scriptures itself does it talk about a separate woman named Wisdom sitting on the right hand side with her own body, her own thing going on outside of the Most High. It's always within the Most High, just as Yahusha is within the Most High, even though he was brought out of him to accomplish, he still paired, married, obedient, subservient to the Most High Yahuwah. And this plan was supposed to be followed down here. You know, within the virtuous woman, she has her role to play within the earth, and Hashatan has pretty much destroyed her role. You know, in the very beginning, he went after the woman because she's more susceptible to being deceived, because her mindset is to be obedient to her husband, just as Yahusha's mindset was obedience to the Father. And he didn't falter on his obedience. Whatever the Father said, do he done. And he never questioned. He never argued with the Most High. He didn't falter. Like the scriptures say, Lay was with Jacob. Never had one accusation against Jacob the whole of her life. And that man loved her immensely. At first, he loved Rachel immensely. But then he grew into loving Leah like fine wine. And it was an immense love for her. And that's what he said about her. He put Leah inside with Sarah. He laid Leah beside Sarah in the tomb that Abraham purchased. So, and we know that Rachel was buried beside a road. I forgot the nearest city by there, but anyway, we know that that's where she ended up at. But he said that she never laid one accusation imitating the son's relationship with the father throughout her life. Pure obedience. Pure. She gave her life as a living sacrifice. Y'all see it? Hallelujah, Yahuah. But anyway, I just want to make sure when y'all are reading this, you're really studying yourself to be proven, not latching yourself onto these other doctrines like that's coming from GOCC, where they're reading this and they're saying that the Holy Spirit is a woman, and the Holy Spirit is separate, and all the, you know, all these different camps and organization that's picking this up, individual people who's calling the Holy Spirit she, that's the wife of the Most High. No, you're far off. You gotta go deeper. Get an understanding that the Most High Spirit is his spirit of power. It's within him. He shares it with us. And that spirit is under his power and control. That spirit is under his full obedience, full subservience to the Most High. Which we should be. That's why we are called his bride, his wife. That's why we're married to Yahusha, who's the husband man. And through him, we are brought back to the Most High in full subservience and obedience. There's a Qadash order here, brothers and sisters, that must be played out according to his word and his will. And it cannot be changed. And people are changing and adding stuff, going into other people's books and records and in their way of worshiping other deities and their way of thinking in their books and adding that to meanings up in here, like the heathens do. And so now you got this separate entity that's called her. Just like they do it when they call Earth Mother Earth, turning into some deity, Gaia. When the Earth ain't nothing but the Earth. The Most High grabbed some dirt from the Earth and made us. That's why it said, okay, the Earth is the mother of us all. But the Father fashioned us out of that dirt. And he blew the breath of life. He gave his life into that body that he made of clay. The same way the man has the sperm of life. And there's a dormant egg laying there in the woman, waiting for life to be breathed into it. the Most High's image is in all that we see, right in your households. I mean, if you're married, you got a wife and kids, you playing out that role of the highest. Even the gay people can't help but play the role out. There's always got to be a man and a woman style in each relationship between a man and a man and or a woman and a woman. Every last relationship you see, if you got two women, one of them is what you call the butch female, the dominant female. Another one is the subservient, obedient, like plays that role. Same thing with the two men. You got the one that's the dominant, that's the masculine, and then you got the other one that plays that feminine out. Even within that structure, even though it's wrong, and then according to the scriptures, you still see the image being portrayed. There's no escape. There's always going to be a king or queen or prince, princess. You're going to always see that role that was set before time. And it doesn't necessarily mean that other person is going to be a woman in an employee role. In an employer and employee role, you see the head, the manager, the supervisor, the leader, the guider, the one that's over you, and you're the submissive, you're the obedient, you're the worker, you're the doer of that job. So there you have the marriage and the pairing right there as well in the workplace. Whether you're a man or a woman as an employee, or whether there's the employer is a man or a woman heading up that division, you have that person in charge. And they guide and lead and direct and teach and to get the job done. Y'all hear what I'm saying? This image of the Most High is just everywhere. Once you get to understand the order and you believe it and it's in your heart, you won't go outside of it. You'll play your role. That's why the Messiah says, servants, obey your masters. And a lot of people would shun that part and say, no, I'm not going to obey them. No, you're being rebellious then. It's the order of things, y'all. Obey your masters. There's nothing wrong with that on your job. That man or that person or woman, whoever's in that position over you, that they're the manager, they're the supervisor, and you're the worker, the employee. They have a job to do in leading, guiding you into doing your job. But then there's somebody over that person, right? And that person becomes the one that's over you becomes the subservient one, being led and guided by another. It's all over the place, brothers and sisters. So let's stop complaining at the workplace about who's over you. Just obey the word and listen to what the Most High is telling you. Represent him on the job. Be the best servant you can be. Because soon next thing you know, you're going to be in that position where you are over employees and they're going to be subject to you and underneath your command. Y'all see what I'm saying? And there's nothing wrong with it, brothers and sisters. Even commanders have the general over them. Just as privates have their officers over them. And it goes on and on and on throughout the whole world, throughout history, throughout time. This has existed in order of things. So when you're reading these scriptures, keep all this in mind as you're reading and you're seeing how they're giving obedience to or bowing down to the kings, even us, other kings, Pharaoh, and you know what I'm saying? Keep all this in mind. Joseph is underneath Pharaoh, but he's over everybody else. He has to obey his master, but not breaking the Most High's laws, statutes, and commandments while he's doing it. Same thing with Daniel. Look at that story as well. Subservient to the emperor, the king, or Nebuchadnezzar, and all the other ones. And he was lifted up to a point where the others was subject to him. So you have this pairing going on of master and servant, employer and employee, man and woman. Y'all see it? Brother over his own brother. The oldest brother over the younger brother. Y'all see it? The father over his son. The obedience and the loyalty, trust, faith is all there. And you're the older father, you know, the father or even the older brother. You have to fulfill your role, your position and place. And the father will add all things unto you. He will add the honor. He will add the whatever he has said he will add to you as you go along, fulfilling his will, staying in your place, whatever position that is at the moment. You will see different things happening in your lives, brothers and sisters. You see it around you. You will see the honor, not because you're searching for it, not because you want it, you desiring it and all that. It's just going to come because you're in order with his will. And he will add all things to you. You know, if you seek ye the kingdom of Shemayim, he will add all things to you. Don't expect it to come all at once. I mean, you're going to be tested and tried throughout all these different positions and places that you're going to find yourself in. Whether you're the master and or the servant, whether you're the husband or the wife, whether you're the brother, the older brother or the younger brother, whether you're the father and over the son or the daughter, or you're going to be tested and tried throughout all these different stages and positions and places. Your faith. But if you learn this word correctly, you will learn how to stay within that role, that position in place, and the shifting of roles, like the Messiah is. You know, he's submissive, subservient to the Most High, but he's the master over us, and he has dominion over us and kingship over us. So he has to lead and guide and command and do all these things, but he also got to look up to the Most High and be subservient and obedient and hear what thus saith the Most High too, just like all of us do. Y'all see it at these different key things. This is what studying yourself to be approved is, and to have the wisdom of the Most High to understand different aspects of the scriptures according to his Qadash well, brothers and sisters. So I just wanted to put that out there. And I'm put a link to that older video about that I did in the past about wisdom. And then I made that video because I saw GLCC and some other groups leading their other people into destruction, you know, misunderstanding. And now that I got an even deeper meaning, I can add to what I knew back then, which I only knew so much when I made that video. But now I know so much more. I can break it down this a little bit more concerning the scripts. And that way y'all could see, okay, I could see how he grown from way back then. That's why I leave a lot of those videos up. You can go back and see where I was back then and then come back forward and see where I am now. And I should be improving, brothers and sisters, year by year, just like you. More knowledge, more wisdom, more understanding, more knowing the Most High and His will and His way. Hallelujah. Yahuah. Thank y'all for watching. Be sure to subscribe and click that notification bell and give me a thumbs up, and definitely share this video. Y'all know where to leave those comments, but email me if you have any questions. And with that, I'm gonna say shalom, brothers and sisters. Hallelujah. Yahuah.